Hello, all you positive heads out there. It's so good to be back with all you beautiful reflections of the one source consciousness that creates and animates all things. If you're new to this podcast, of course, we are super happy to have you here, and we just ask that you bring an open mind and heart to your listening experience and to be prepared to explore vantage points that I'm convinced will help shift or solidify your current understanding of the ultimate nature of reality in a way that is extremely empowering. Speaking of exploring powerful perspectives, I'm super excited to announce the release of my very first book, The Golden Key: Modern Alchemy to Unlock Infinite Abundance. If you're ready to alchemize the circumstances in your life so that your abundance expands to an entirely new level in 2021, head over to goldenkey.gift to download the audio or ebook as my gift to you by using the code POSITIVEHEAD.
All right, all you positive heads, welcome. Welcome one and all. I thank you so much for joining me today. You know, I said last week that last week was an interesting week, and today, unfortunately, Samantha couldn't join me. And so today I thought I would talk about all the things I learned last week and how interesting of a week it really was. And it was a really stressful week, and I've been hearing from others that it was a stressful week for them as well. And so I think it's just the energy and the theme of what's going on. And yeah, I think there's a few things I want to talk about. One of those things is how to deal with our stress. And actually, it's funny, I didn't intend to talk about this, but as I turn the mic on and I start talking, this is what is coming up, is how to deal with the stress that is coming up in our lives and what we can do about it. Because I had a situation come up last week that was super stressful and was ongoing for months, and there was nothing I can do about it. And at the same time, while there was nothing I could do about it, I also knew that there was nothing that I did wrong or anything I could have done differently to change the situation. And so, but still, I had so much stress about it. And I also knew that I was going to be all right and everything was going to be all right. And even though I had that knowing, I was still stressing out about it. And I had to talk myself down a lot. And so this is one of the things that I think I want to bring up, is talking ourselves down and really using the power of our will to change our thoughts when things are going awry in our world, right? So we can allow ourselves to spiral down a pathway of really getting ourselves more and more stressed out, thinking of all the awful things that could possibly happen, the ifs, ands, the whats, and all the whoozy things. And or we could just stop. We could just stop it and tell ourselves it's all going to be okay. It's all going to be okay. I did everything I could. I did the best I could. And that is that. Everything's going to be okay. And so that's what I did for myself last week, is I just continually reminded myself that it's okay. Everything is going to be okay. And what's really interesting is in one of those moments where I was having a little bit of a stress out and reminding myself that I was okay, I look up in the sky and there's this huge, beautiful cloud that immediately I think is an angel. And I think, wow, what a beautiful sign this is. And so I go to grab my phone and take a picture of it. And as I'm doing that, I realize, oh, this isn't an angel. It's a dragon. Even better. Not even better, because, I mean, you know, angels, dragons, there's no, you know, hierarchy here. But in terms of what I was going through, it was perfect. The dragon is symbolic of like fierce protection. It's like the keeper of the four elements of all that is here. And it was just the best sign for me to see, yeah, you are protected. Everything is just fine. Everything is just fine. And as it turned out, everything was just fine. And there was no reason for me to stress out and get myself all up in a tizzy. And I knew that going through it, and I was able to talk myself down, but I still did it. I still allowed myself to get stressed out. And it was totally unnecessary. It was totally unnecessary. And so I want to share that with you all because we all do this to ourselves. And, you know, some of us really let ourselves spiral more than others. And this is a little reminder for you to stop it. Just stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it and reframe your thought process. Tell yourself it's okay. It's going to be okay, right? Everything is always okay. And everything that is happening for us. We need to remember always, this is always happening for us, even though it doesn't make sense in that moment how this is possibly happening for me, but it is. It's never happening to us. We are not the victim here. The things that we feel like are happening to us are just those opportunities for us to help ourselves learn and grow along this journey, along this beautiful alchemical archetypal journey that we are going through as souls. And it really is a beautiful opportunity. And so this week, I saw for myself so many opportunities. These certainly were challenges, but these were opportunities for me to stand in my own power. And by my own power, what I mean by that is my ability to say, I did everything I could. I functioned to the best of my ability. And I also know that I didn't do anything wrong here and that I can stand in my integrity knowing that, right? And that I'm not going to let somebody try to push me around or tell me otherwise because this is my belief system and I'm going to stand strong in that. And it feels really, really, really good when you're challenged in these ways to be able to stand up in this way and have everything be okay. It's always okay. It's always okay. It might be stressful, but it's always okay. It's such a beautiful world we live in. And really, it's a matter of our perspective. We can choose to look at things in the light or in the shadow. It's all the oneness. It's just, how do we choose to look at it? We get to decide. That's what's so amazing about this. It's our choice. It's totally our choice. And so the other thing that happened last week is that my week was like bookended by, on Monday, the most difficult session I think I've ever done in 7 years of practicing QHHT. And the most amazing, incredibly ridiculous session I've ever done practicing QHHT in 7 years on Friday. And so this week had this like two polar opposite experiences contained within it. And it really made me think a lot about what the difference was between these two clients. And it was all a matter of perspective at the end of the day. It's a matter of belief and perspective. And that was the difference in these two sessions. And the session that was completely amazing, the reason why it was so amazing is because this client came in with an understanding that everything is within him and that he just needs to find the understanding. He needs to basically sit and talk through it and have some help and some guidance to talk through the things that he has already been working on, the things that he's already been putting the work into, and also understands that this voice, this communication, doesn't come from an outside being or an outside source, that it is all contained within. And because he came in with this understanding, what happened was during the interview part of this, of the session, which sessions are about, you know, five or six hours long. And the first couple hours, and sometimes more, are spent just talking and learning about their life. Like for me, learning about their life and just asking questions. And so he was struggling with something very, very difficult. And I asked him, well, what is it that you've learned from this situation so far? And he just kind of thought for a moment, and he was listening to his higher self guidance. I could tell. And he looked back at me and he goes, compassion. I learned compassion. And he looked back over, because the way he was listening to his guidance, and this is a really amazing trick as an aside, not trick, but way to understand it within yourself. And this is how I started understanding it within myself and saw him doing, and he didn't even realize that he was doing this either. So what it is he was listening to this voice that was on the right side of him, on the right side of his brain. And then when he was consciously talking to me from his left side of his brain, he would actually look on that side and then look at me and talk to me as from, you know, his conscious perspective. And it was very distinct, very, very different. And that's exactly how I hear my guidance. I hear it off to the right, kind of up a little higher. And my conscious thoughts are always just kind of in my head on the left. And so it feels different to me. And so I sat there watching him have this kind of communication going on. And he went back and he listened to more of what they were saying. And it was like he was just getting this download as we were sitting there. And he turned back to me and he described to me more about the lesson. And as he was describing it to me and the entirety of it, as he was doing that, the light bulb just went off within him. And I was watching this, and it was such a beautiful thing and such an honor to be witness to watch this healing happen in front of my eyes, because this is the way that healing happens. It is an understanding of the lesson. And when you get it, when you truly, truly get it, when you understand, when that light bulb moment happens, it is instantaneous, this understanding. It's a light bulb moment because the light within you then shines and that darkness lifts. And literally, I watched it. I watched this darkness or this heaviness, this density just lift from him as he had this understanding and this light bulb moment. And I just sat there and just watched in amazement as he healed himself in that moment. And he looked at me. And of course, you know, this is, I'm just sitting there and holding the space for him as he processes and goes through this. And he sat there for a moment and he looked at me and he said, I feel at peace. I'm not really sure that, but this feels like normal. I haven't really felt normal before, but I think this is what normal feels like. I feel at peace. Wow. He's like, I don't think I've felt this in, I can't remember when. And all because he literally listened in his waking state to his higher self and was able to then gain the awareness and the understanding of why he went through what he went through, the whole purpose of it, gain that understanding, and that's it. Healing. That's how healing happens. It is so, so simple. And we don't need to be in a trance state in order for that to happen.
Before we continue on with today's episode, I'd like to take a quick moment to tell you about our sponsor, NOOM. NOOM is a unique habit-changing solution that helps users learn to develop a new relationship with food. And it's not a diet. No food is considered good or bad. As we talk about on this show all the time, it's all about proper balance and having good habits. And NOOM just teaches you how to look within your own mind and make better decisions for yourself. Sounds familiar, right? It's based in psychology, eating better to feel better. It focuses on the story that we tell around food and how to feel good about our choices. And they make it all super easy to do with a minimal commitment of only 10 minutes a day, which is essential for someone like me with so much on my plate. pun intended. So if you guys would like to try out the cognitive behavioral approach to losing weight that has led to 80% of Noomers finishing the program and 60% sticking to their goals for at least 1 year, head over to Noom.com/positive head to start your trial today. That's spelled Noom.com/positive head. I mean, what do you have to lose except outdated habits and perhaps a few extra pounds by signing up for the trial? Once again, that's Noom.com/positive head. Check it out.
And wow, you know, of course we understand this, but you know, we think that we need to go do this technique, have this thing done to us in order for that to happen. Well, it's not necessary. We can do it ourselves if we ask ourselves these questions and really examine it, gain an understanding. Then we can heal ourselves without having to use any technique. And of course, it's a lot easier to have somebody to guide you into this beautiful deep state of relaxation where it's much easier to hear this voice inside your head that's always there. But it's not necessary. We have this ability, this power within ourselves. And what's really, really cool about this session is that a lot of the information that came through was exactly the information that came through when I was last put out into a trance state. And I played a little clip of that for you guys. I don't know, maybe the week before last. And it was a little bit about flying and how we can do that now, how we actually have the ability to do that now. And the only thing that's holding us back is our belief that we can't, and the collective belief that we can't, and our density, the fact that we are so, so dense. All of this, he said in his session, like almost the exact same words that I did. And so that was such beautiful confirmation to understand and to know how intensely powerful we are as individuals and as a collective. And while we might not be able to fly in our material bodies as we exist in them right now, the knowing that we could and that we can if we changed our belief system is huge. Absolutely huge. And another really big thing that came through him was very relevant to what was happening on Monday in the very difficult session. They were saying that so many people have such a hard time trusting themselves, and that we as humans are so incredibly stubborn. We just have such a hard time, and we doubt ourselves so, so much. And I tell you what, I can't tell you how many times these higher selves are encouraging us to just stop it. Stop doubting ourselves. Listen to ourselves. Trust ourselves. This is how we evolve. This is how life stops being difficult. This is how life can stop being stressful. And we don't need to have illnesses or difficulties, because when we can trust ourselves and listen to ourselves and do the things that our inner being is helping us or trying to tell us to do, when we follow that direction and we just go with the flow, everything is just so simple, and we don't need these opportunities to help us to learn to get over that hump, because that's all they are. These challenges in life are just beautiful opportunities to help us learn and grow. And when we understand that it is all about us, it is within us, everything is within us, within our power, then we get it. We totally get it. The opposite of that, which is what makes life more difficult, or what would make a session more difficult, is when you resist that flow, or when you don't trust yourself, or when you allow your conscious mind focus to run away with you and to spiral down into stress. That is when life is difficult. I love that a session is such a metaphor for how we can just do life. And this is why I love working with this technique so much, is because this is what a session will teach you, kind of how to do life, how to go through life and go with the flow and listen to your inner guidance, which you don't need a session to do, but that's why I love doing them. So again, this is all within you. This is not something outside of you that comes and takes care of it for you, because I'll tell you what, that is not going to happen. And as a matter of fact, right now, the time that we are in is so intense that they're really not doing it for us as much as they were in the past. Now they're really calling us forward to do it ourselves. And if we're not taking that effort and that personal responsibility to really examine ourselves and take the time and to trust ourselves and to listen to ourselves and to love ourselves, if we are not doing that for ourselves, it's going to be tough. It's going to be really tough. But know that if it is tough for you right now, know that you have help, and all that you need to do is ask. Ask for help and then trust. Trust and listen. It's so simple. We just need to get out of our own way, because we all have this ability. And if you don't think you do, it's just because the perception, the belief, the focus. Change your focus, change your belief. Start trusting yourself. Know that you have the answers within you. And it is your choice. It is your choice whether you want to go through life flailing in the water, or if you want to go through life realizing, I don't need to do that. I can float. I don't need to flail about. I don't need to be afraid that I'm going to drown. I can float. I can just relax, and I can lay back, and I can let the water hold me. And this water has all the answers. I am one with it. I'm one with all. All the answers are within me. I love you all so much. I'm leaving you with that for today and this beautiful song by Symbolico called The Answer. Until next time, I love you all so much.
Also, quickly, before we cue up today's song, I wanted to remind you to download the Golden Key audio or ebook as my free gift to you at goldenkey.gift using the code POSITIVEHEAD. I also wanted to remind you that I will now be doing a live Q&A every Thursday night at 6 p.m. Pacific time on the new social audio app Clubhouse. I have really been wanting to connect and interact with all of you more for quite some time, and I'm super excited to now have two new ways to do it. First, if you're already on Clubhouse, be sure to follow me and click the little bell on my profile and select to always be notified when I go live on the Clubhouse app. And if you'd like to connect on an even more intimate Zoom gathering once a month, now you can do that too by registering at goldenkey.gift.
You are the answer. awesome.
I'm not going to be able to do that.